Go to the Tools panel of Affinity Photo and select any shape. I'm just going to go with the Rectangle tool and just create a quick rectangle. Once you've done that, what you can do, you can go to Layer and down to New Live Filter Layer and then go to Colors and Procedural Texture. So with that, just brings this up and you can go for any of the presets. I'm just going to go with, say, black and white. So black and white one doesn't particularly matter which one you go with, just go with something. So once you've done that, you can close it. So it's closed. You can see now in the Layers panel, and that's in View and Studio and Layers. And you can see Procedural Texture. However, what I want to do is I want to go to File and Edit in Designer. So as soon as I do that, and you need Designer. If you haven't got Designer, this won't work, obviously. It needs Photo and also Designer. So I'm just going to remove the Appearance one and Stars. Don't need those anymore. But now what you can see, Layers. And you can see Procedural Texture. That is stored over there with that rectangle, which is quite useful because what you can do, you can now double click on that. And with double clicking that, you've got exactly the same preset settings there. So the black and white, it's still there. And you can also got all these presets. So you can go down here and say, oh, I want fur or whatever. Some obviously work better than others, say like checkered. So you've got checkered there. And you can see the design and you can, of course, modify it. You can modify the equation, all those sort of things within Affinity Designer. Now, also what you can do, of course, maybe not, of course, because it might not work, but I'm just moving that. Just move that over there. And I can just go over here for another shape. So I'm just going to go for a star design. So something like that. Now, with that, what I can do, I can just go there and I can just drag that one up to filters. And instead of being on there, it's now on this star design, which is super useful because it means you can use procedural textures in Affinity Designer. It isn't naturally in there. There's no filter commands. So what you can also do, which is super useful as well, and I'm just going to remove that now because I don't need it. What you can do, go to View Menu and Studio and then go down to Assets. And if assets turn up, there's assets. There it is. You can resize that. And you've got over here, you've got an option here. Various things here. Settings. You can go to these ones. I'm just looking down which one's probably the best. Miscellaneous. Why not? Span that. So miscellaneous, you can see all the different designs there. You can go right click and that one's selected now. Add from selection. So I'm just adding that one from selection. Now what I can do, I can remove it. So, assume you haven't done anything or you just close everything, you go off and you go and do some other things and you come back a couple of days later and you think, you know what, I want to use procedural textures. You don't have to go through the same route. What you do, simply go over here and maybe create some shapes and designs. But also what you can do, you can drag your star over from there. You've just stored it over there. And you notice what you've got. You've got your procedural texture, which of course then what you can do, you can just go there and you can select it, drag it down again to that. And now you've added to any design that you've added there. And now you can go double click again, bring up the panel and modify it and maybe change mine and go for clouds or some other one, mono swirls, whatever that is. So you can see now you've got basically got procedural textures inside Affinity Designer. Okay, it's a bit fiddly way of doing it, but it's there for use. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.